Our old friend the Meg is back. The supersized predator of the deep has had a long history, a history that may not be over. The shark was in the news again after math was used to verify the size of the animal. So, was it as large or even larger than they say? Did it really die out? And could it still be cruising the deep, being spotted from time to time? Let's take a look. Welcome to IF, videos on history, mystery, and the strange. Hit that subscribe button and ring the bell so you never miss a video again. The enormous shark has become a celebrity of the deep, people being in awe over the idea that such a beast could have once, and possibly still does, cruise the oceans. The supersize of the prehistoric mega shark has been capitalized on, with Hollywood films using the Meg as the terror of many a seafaring man and woman. The actual size of the shark has been up for debate, with some widely different measurements being put forward for the animal. The size is mostly based upon the finding of the teeth and using measurements from today's sharks like the great white. The measurements are sized up for the Meg. Recently, however, a team from Swansea and Bristol universities have combined maths with nature to reveal just exactly how big the Megalodon was. The recent study was published in the journal Scientific Reports. The university researchers applied mathematical methods and comparisons with the Megalodon's closest living relatives. This, a process that is often used to reconstruct victims of crime. Humans, like all animals, share common characteristics, and therefore, the matching muscle groups can be applied to all members of a species. This before the final steps of individualized characteristics are added using clues from bone. The teeth of the Meg point to it having an overall size of 16 meters or 52 feet in length, the Megalodon being almost three times the size of the largest great white shark. Measurements put its head around 4.65 meters or 15 feet in length. Its iconic dorsal fin was as large as an entire adult human, and it had a tail of 3.85 meters or 13 foot in height. Jack Cooper, who is to study a PhD in paleobiology at Swansea University, described the research as his dream project. Megalodon was the very animal that inspired me to pursue paleontology. But studying the whole animal is difficult considering all we really have are lots of isolated teeth, he said. It's significant that we have now been able to produce estimates of proportions and dimensions of the body parts when there were, and are, no fossils to go off. However, the dimensions in the recent film were actually pretty accurate, he finished with. There are also a growing number of cryptozoologists, zoologists, and biologists who think that it is a possibility that the animal may still live. There have been many reports of the shark. Some are convinced the Megalodon still lives. One of the first reported sightings of what is thought to be a Megalodon comes from HMS Challenger. Back in 1875, the British vessel HMS Challenger dredged up a pair of what was thought to be freshly shed Megalodon teeth from the seafloor. Dr. W. Chersnesky of London's Queen Mary College attempted to date the teeth by studying the buildup of the manganese dioxide layer on each tooth. After examining the manganese dioxide deposits, the doctor claimed that the teeth were in fact around 11,000 to 24,000 years old. Although this date is the distant past, it would, if correct, show that the Megalodon survived far more recently, living well past the 2.3 to 2.6 million year date given for its extinction. Those that are skeptical say that the manganese dioxide dating method is not reliable, especially when trying to use it to date sharks' teeth. Cryptozoologist Ben S. Roisch reviewed the doctor's findings and wrote that the Meg's and other sharks' teeth are extremely hardy, more so than that of other types of fossil. This means that the methods used to date archaic animal remains cannot be used accurately with recovered Megalodon teeth. So if we cannot trust the findings of the doctor, And these relatively young teeth, in terms of the historical record, may be we can find sightings of a living creature that are more compelling. One such story comes from a David Steed and the tale of a giant fish. Mr. Steed penned the book Sharks and Rays of the Australian Seas. The Australian naturalist retold the story, in which he believes witnesses describe a megalodon. The story goes as follows. It's 1981, and David spoke with several cray fishermen who had become terrified to go back out at sea. They were fearful of a shark, which they saw cruising their fishing grounds off Broughton Island. The men claimed that this shark was an animal of unbelievable size. It was swimming through their pots and was so large it easily dragged the crayfish pots and the mooring away with it as it swam. This would be no easy feat, as these fishing pots were over 3 feet in diameter and loaded with a heavy catch. Steed and the local fisheries inspector, a Mr. Patton, quizzed the men. They told the same story of a monstrously sized predator. One witness claimed that its head alone was at least as long as the roof on the wharf shed at Nelson's Bay. Many said it measured around 115 feet in length. Others said the water seemed to boil when it surfaced. All of them were convinced that it was a shark rather than a whale, and that it was pale white in its colouring. The story is compelling, as these men were familiar with the ocean and could easily identify sharks, whales, and other ocean-going creatures. Sticking with Australia and one of the most important ecosystems on the planet, the Great Barrier Reef. In the 60s, a monster shark was said to have been spotted there, again seen by men who were no strangers to the ocean. A group of sailors told that when their 85-foot ship was forced to weigh anchor for engine repairs, the captain and crew were surprised when they saw a huge white shark swim slowly past their stuck ship. The beast was no great white, as it was way too large, matching the size of the broken down vessel. This story brings us to another about a giant cryptid shark known as the Black Demon. The Black Demon is a shark that is claimed to be bigger than the massive megalodon and is said to be lurking in the waters off the Californian coast. It has been said that fishermen in the Pacific Ocean have reported several first-hand experiences with the terrifying beast. More evidence is claimed to come in the form of hundreds of whales which have been discovered dead and show signs of being attacked by a mysterious huge predator of some unknown type. There are even those that say they have survived encounters with the giant black creature of the deep, an animal that they say was the same as a massive shark with a huge mouth filled with many razor-sharp pointed teeth. This being one of the defining features of the creature, and is probably the feature that most defines a megalodon. The local fishermen report seeing huge shadows under the water, with their claims being taken seriously and investigated by scientists. There have been hundreds of sightings of the shark, particularly near Baja California, Mexico. A local fisherman saw a huge shadow under the water, and his claims are being investigated by scientists from around the world. The story is now attracting the attention of task force and TV channels hoping to catch a snap of the creature. As of yet, there is no concrete evidence for the Black Demon's existence. Despite this, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, NOAA, has previously admitted it is hard to rule out the possibility of the many claims of sightings of the animal. They revealed how as much as 95% of the world's ocean and 99% of the ocean floor remains unexplored and would provide ample space for the animal to hide. Visiting these regions of the deep is difficult and time-consuming, as well as being vastly expensive. So do you think this monster of the deep is still swimming the deepest depths of the world's oceans? Are we likely to find the Meg? And does this put you off of venturing out into the ocean? Let me know in the comments below. As always, if you like what I do here on the channel, hit that red button, like, and share. You can catch the latest by searching We Are If. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Next time